Take your hobby to the next level with a quality racing rig that works great with a PS3, Xbox 360, and a PC. Omega Racing Simulator is compatible with a wide range of steering wheels, including Logitech, Fanatic, Thrustmaster, and more. The GT Omega is available now worldwide by going to www.gtomegaracing.com.
Welcome to ARL TV. I'm Mike Simpson. I'm joined in the commentary box by Dean Prescott today. Dean, you're not racing this afternoon, but we're going to cover your series, the Grand Am here at Mid-Ohio.
That's correct, Alex.
Tell us a little bit about the challenges of this circuit before the flag drops in just a minute or so's time.
I was quite looking forward to coming here actually this week, and then turned my first lap and was spinning everywhere, so just as you can see through the final-ish bend there, from what I can see. But no, there's plenty of crest to get the car sideways, very quick back straight, but there on out it's just pretty much single line.
The guys are just finishing their warm-up laps and, just queuing onto the grid now, so can we just take a quick look at the grid?
We can. On pole position we have Chi with a very fast 115.8. That's definitely the fastest I've seen all week. In second we have Sebastian, who's just sitting behind me in the championship. Third we have Ricardo. Fourth is Gannett. Fifth is Andre. Sixth is Conrad Venter. Seventh is Joe Jacalone. Eighth is Russ. Ninth is Gerard, 10th is PJ, who we've seen before. That's the Rileys, and in the MP4s we have Johan. I'm gonna kill this one. Sespa?
Looks right to me.
Third we have Luigi, who's one of the Team GT guys.
Yeah, I think we last saw him at Mossport. Sorry, Canada Motorsport Park, whatever it is now.
I think I'm going to kill this one again. In fourth for the MP4s, we have Kesaluga. Fifth is Paolo. Sixth is Jean. Seventh is Dennis. Eighth is Andy. Ninth, Shamar. Adam. Claudia. Troy and Jubu.
It's quite a full grid out there today.
Yes, it's not split, but it does look like one of the biggest that I've seen so far. So just going out on the parade lot now. Very difficult actually to get going on this, because you have to back up so much to let the pace car in, and then the green flag pretty much drops as you're going through the left-hand kink. Just in the previous race, I was still halfway around the final one right-hander when the green flag dropped.
Yeah, it's good to see the MP4s backing off just to give them a bit of room.
tricky track. The race that I've just done, which was on just before this, was in a battle pretty much the whole race for second. Managed to come out on top, 107 points. And it looks like it's going to be quite a big strength of field as well, actually.
Yeah, who's the main guys to keep an eye on here? Who's doing well in the championship at the moment?
Chai, Chi, Sebastian, Ricardo, they're all pretty much up there. I mean, you can see the qualifying times there, 115 to one low 116, so definitely going to be a bit of a split. I have seen these guys doing it on race pace as well, so. But here we go, final corner's coming up. Pace car will peel in and then we're underway.
As lights come on, we're racing here, mid-Ohio. It's like a clean start for the most part for the Rileys. Let's just quickly
not
see.
Not so much for the MP4s though. I think all but one made it through turn one.
See time lap today, time race even, time lap, must be losing it.
Yeah, you're looking about 37 or so laps, I think. 39 actually, is the last race. Maybe these guys could fill in one more. Some action through the field, the MP4s are having a little battle. Getting sideways into the heavy braking zone.
Yeah, that uphill left-hander, extremely tricky little tricky corner, no matter what car you're in. Catches a lot of drivers out. There's so many lines you can take through there as well. I think we saw that there just as everybody filtered through it. It's, you compromise so many different corners on this circuit for the next one, and it's which ones you compromise and where you're at. That's why we see so many different lines as well. This last corner, I think I can take that a different way every lap of the race.
Yeah, you just need to find one that's suitable for yourself. A little bottle there just behind. Not sure
what it is. Yeah, the MP4 pack seems to be spreading a lot apart a little bit towards the front, but it's all where it's all the midfield where it's going on. Let's just have a little check in with Chi at the front, just see how he's doing. He's opened up quite a considerable lead already. Here we are, halfway through the second lap.
I think the problem with the Rileys is he's pretty much rear end dependent. So coming over these crests, you're short shifting to make sure that it's not stepping out, but there will be that one time where it will bite you and throw you out.
You should be quite familiar with that now. You've drove the V8 supercar for long enough, and that beast was like that all the time.
Yeah, exactly, but this is not what you expect. You expect it to be planted and take the corners as quick as it can, but here it's just completely the opposite.
Let's just check in with our Apex Racing UK driver, give him the plug while he is. He just goes wide, he'll kick me for that later. Tuning in, it's Pink Riley, Conrad Venter.
Again, though, you say he's run wide, you can take that 7,000 different ways and still get a good run. But yeah, pretty much here on out, he's just coasting, letting the car do his thing. Don't push it, it will bite you. Especially over this first bump into the double apex right-hander.
We've got a little battle here, down to this corner, right-hander. This has got the tricky left-hander blind at the top. Need to switch back. This right-left-right section.
And did really well and to actually hold on.
It's a great flowing track actually, Mid-Ohio. It's just a shame. What we want is a couple of the straights just to be a bit longer, just to help facilitate overtaking that a little bit more. It'll be a very tricky track at times to get past.
And an even trickier track to get past slower cars. Seeing some new camera angles here actually, Alex.
Yeah, I have to say thanks to Istvan for them. I'm just checking them out now, some of them, so if it looks a bit out of order, let me just switch into internal when there's a battle going on. Forgive me, once I learn the cameras, we'll focus on the proper ones. But yeah, big shout out to Istvan for doing that. He supplies us with all the camera files. Saves a whole load of time. It's a very frustrating little job, so he does them well. And I look forward to seeing what the Road America one's like when we switch to the Road to Pro later on.
That's right, just brought out the DP on Mid-Ohio. I think he already had a few for the MP4, but I tweaked some of them. Definitely some good cinematic shots though. Just looking at the static cameras. Seems like we've got two drivers in the pits in the MP4s. Not sure what might happen there. Seems to have another little battle for the back two of the Rileys.
Yeah, 7th and 8th, Jacqueline and Miguel.
I'm seeing Gerard. And Joe. Two guys that I've not seen before, actually.
Yeah, I mean, how has this series been? Obviously, it got quite a boost last season when the MP4 came to it, and I think it became quite popular. But I know they're sort of running with the GT class cars as well, so is it spreading participation now? Have you seen that drop off? Or
it does hold its own, depending on what track it is. If it's a popular track like Watkins Glen, you'll probably see three splits, whereas here you're probably only going to get to see the one split. See how difficult it is actually to follow here. You're just slightly off centre with your braking points. Sends you wide. Not been too bad. See Gerard. And you see two different lines under the open.
You get a much better exit out that way, and you can see that there. It closed in a lot on the braking, but driving away down the straight.
Closes up under the brakes though. Again, there's a few different braking points for the back straight. Depends how risky you want to be.
Yeah, I remember driving this circuit a lot in the IndyCar, and you can sort of brake a lot gentler, but a lot earlier on that back straight, and you get fantastic amount of rotation going in, so a lot of grip on the front end and can really help. So yeah, I can imagine there's people doing something like that and also hammering right up to it, braking a little bit later and getting the car to turn in that way.
Just don't do what most people are seen doing this week. You just completely miss it and you just go straight on. Can be very frustrating.
Just quickly check in on the front of the MP4, see what's going on there. We've got Johan leading at the moment. He's 2.1 seconds up at the moment. He's lapped a couple of tenths quicker that last time by just a tenth actually, as they've crossed the line now from Luigi. We saw these guys actually have a great battle at, I'm going to say again. Yeah, there we go. It'll always be my spot to me.
Yeah, but will be to me as well.
But yeah, they were changing places all over the shot, and I remember I think it was Johan was trying to get past around the outside on the second from last corner a lot and getting it all sorts of wrong, and I think in the end they ended up exactly where they started, just behind. So it seems to have the Johan seems to have the pace on him this week, just pulling that little bit of a gap.
Yeah, lap times are pretty much even up until this point. I'm sure we'll see what kind of lap times they'll be getting once the Rileys catch up.
Yeah, it's quite a short lap, so I guess traffic's going to come into play quite a bit, and we've got a lot of cars on the grid today, so a good sort of split. We've got nine Rileys.
Chai's actually starting to catch up to the back of the MP4s.
Yeah, and just see him in the distance there. Last time by he did 1:17.8, so 0.7 of a second faster than Ricardo.
Yeah, I'm not sure that's quite surprised at that pace. His first few laps were in the 16s. Starting to drop off a little bit now into the 17s.
Yeah, he wasn't the fastest person on the track. Actually, the quickest person out there was Sebastian. And he's really starting to put the pressure on Ricardo, which is maybe why Ricardo's dropping back a little bit.
Yeah, quicker again by full second, actually.
Yeah, 17.5 that time by. Chi up front, back into the 16.996, so he extends his lead just that little bit.
He's made it past the two McLarens as well. We're actually having a good old little scrap, actually. Just shows you don't have to be the quick guys to have a little battle. Again, pretty much like last sport, Canadian tyre, it's just a battle of the Subaru. You can keep your rhythm, not get too much pressure. Should be good to go.
Yeah, we saw that a lot actually. The Canadian tyre, it was all about just, one of the MP4s just diving out of the way there. What's your take on that? Obviously you're a Riley driver. I appreciate you want the drivers to get out of the way, but does something like that put you off more when drivers just do random things like, you know, just like leave it right to the last minute and just jump wide? And
yes and no. I do like them to keep the line, but there is the odd point where, like that time he was just lapping on his own. Could see the two battling cars behind. And he did actually everything right there, he just got a wheel on the grass as he was braking. But yeah, there's a few times where I've been stuck behind somebody and they've
Sebastian taking a look here. Trying to use the MP4 there again, just decides to take it off track just to get out of the way of these two.
Yeah, you just want them to have a bit of common sense if they're on their own. There's two battling cars like we have there. Just think, come on, got a minute. Just jump out of the way. But let them know beforehand that you're going to do it as well.
We last saw Sebastian, obviously, Canadian Tyre as well, and he was smashing it that week. I remember being good 10, 12 seconds in the lead and just pushed it a little bit on the last corner and got it all wrong. Wheel on the outside, curb and grass, and come and hit the pit wall.
Yeah, it was turn one actually, when you just went on board with him.
But yeah, let's hope we don't do anything like that today.
You can see there the lap time. He actually dropped off a second, just trying to get past that MP4. Right there is actually a good example of an MP4. It's 22 battling cars passed.
Yeah, I think when you're you're being lapped, doesn't matter what car it is, whether it's in different class or not, you just need to be aware of the guys coming up, and you either let them. I think it's always best to let someone go before the corner if you're going to do that, or you stay wide enough to let them take you through the apex. There's a lot of drivers I see try and hold on to the corner and then let you go on the following straight coming out of the corner, just have a little lift or something like that. It's just don't have to get in the way. I think that's the worst for any driver, because it's very unpredictable when you come out of a corner.
It does work both ways though as well, so there's been many a times where I've been way out in front, sat in second with a 15 second gap behind me, come up to two MP4s and I've just let them battle and got past when I can. So Sebastian just slightly losing his braking point there. It's actually been quite tricky on the setup again this week. All these crests, off camber corners. It just tends to make the car of Sebastian slide it over the crest. Again, prime example of just trying to get that power down too early. It'll bite you.
Just take a quick little look at that back on board.
Is everything right?
Yeah, like you say, he's just getting hard on it over the crest. Just goes light. Car carries on rotating round. You can see there the front damage on that front right. Let's just see if he pops in the carry-on.
He carried on, but he was very sideways again. Went around the final corner.
Maybe
he'll throw it into the box this time. Great car control now. That has entered that little battle.
Yeah, it's got quite a lot of damage there, even on the right, on the rear wing to the right hand side as well. So let's just have a little look further back, see what's going on. Checking on the running order as it stands. We've got,
look at that traffic jam there, actually.
Crazy. Conrad just right in the middle of that. Yeah, we've got Chi followed by Ricardo. Sebastian still holds third. Andre in fourth, Bartlett in fifth, Fenton sixth, Joe in seventh, Gerard in eighth, Russ in tenth. That's the Rileys. Johan still leads the way as far as the MP4s go, followed by Luigi, Estrosteth, Paolo, Sean, Barnett.
Still, this battle goes on between Paolo, P12 and 13. And the MP4s, they're still battling hard. I can see the traffic there actually. I think those four guys, including Conrad, were a few seconds apart. Until they've started lapping traffic. You've just got Ricardo coming up to the back of these and people that are battling.
Yeah, Chi 10 seconds in the front now, so he's just driving away with it. I think Sebastian had the pace to perhaps keep up, but yeah, couldn't get himself past. Ricardo just left to run away with it. Got a little bit wide there. Just again, definitely see a lot of that actually. This place, not so much previous tracks that we've covered, but yeah, definitely drivers just getting off the track, getting out of the way.
Yeah, I think in that case, Paolo just saw Ricardo in his mirrors last minute. Ricardo was just holding his guns.
It's interesting.
We've got the top end.
Two Team GT drivers sat in second place in each series at the moment.
They're the ones who seem to bring most team-wise to the races. Very often I've raced a few of them, Ricardo included. It's always rather interesting when you're right behind Ricardo and then coming up on his MP4 teammate.
Yeah, I can imagine. Any team orders going on to try and block you, or jump out of the way?
I wouldn't say so much team orders, but the fact that he's in the same team as him, maybe just hold you back a little bit. See a bit of impatience from the Riley. It's St. Claudia onto the grass and spinning. Just held his line through turn one and then got back on the power. But still, this battle is now starting to include Conrad.
I think Claudio just gave a little way too much room there, didn't need to go as wide and run the risk of just getting a wheel onto the grass. Snapped a bit hard there. Some places here, like with slow enough speed that you can afford to do that, but turn one, certainly not. Yeah, the little battle actually just in front of Conrad's heating up as well, fourth and fifth.
It's been very wide,
Andre
though.
And Garnett.
Just in his position. See there, the MP4 he's in no man's land. Why is he trying to battle these guys?
Yeah.
And he puts a big dent in the back of Andre. Garnett's now through.
He's got a whole load more Rileys to deal with here, so. What Conrad wants to see, just a little bit sideways, so that'll work quite nicely.
It's quite lucky actually, because that's pretty much the last overtaking point there. Until possibly you come over the next crest.
Let's just jump on board with Conrad actually for the next lap. You just take us through it.
Can do. Around the final corner. Flat out and watch that bump on the exit actually. So I'm just flat out now. Fifth, fourth gear. Down into third. Hold it as tight as you can. Now back on. Fourth. Maybe touch into fifth. Braking just where those tyre marks are. Down into first. Many different lines, cars looking a little bit washy there actually, but back on the power. Flat out all the way up into fifth, this is the fastest part of the circuit. Defending a little bit in there, Conrad. Turn on the brakes, I was coming into first gear, pretty much here, revving it and then letting it rev out up and over the crest. Keep it in first again. Hard on the gas, second, short shift into third over that crest, then back into second. Sometimes taking it in third, I was over there as well, now back on the power. Third, start to run out, so into fourth, back down to third, maybe second, and then just up and over the crest, run it down into first gear, and back back on the power again, watching that bump, it will kick you and then straight on again. And that is a very short lap actually.
Yeah, it does look like he's having to work that car quite hard as well, just to keep it underneath him.
I'm not sure what Sasaki's got running actually. It looks like he was having the same problems as I was earlier on today. Not much mid-corner rotation. But again, it's been a difficult track to get the car set up for.
This is pretty much the main battle that's on track at the moment, so we'll stick with it just as Joe goes a little bit wide.
Click through, there's nothing in the MP4s.
No, I was just looking as well. They've all spaced themselves out quite a bit. Obviously, Paolo lost some time earlier on when he obviously went wide just out of the way of the Riley. So, yeah. Out front, obviously, Cheese is smashing it. 15.9 seconds last time by, so. But that said, Ricardo's under no pressure as well, so there's no need for him to push hard to try and catch back up.
Twenty laps in, so fairly into this. So 39 total, maybe 40, so about a halfway point. Conrad actually put his fastest lap in that last lap. 118.7. See, Gerard is just still holding his line, waiting for him to have another little twitch. Conrad did say he just wants to keep his nose clean as he's caught up to the back of somebody there.
Yeah, the MP4 there, not. Didn't need to.
Ball.
Yeah, he didn't need to get out of the way there, but I'm surprised he didn't on that back straight. Actually, that little one there. So we've got a right train of Riley's waiting to get through here. What's the speed difference? I mean, it doesn't look like a great deal. So
off the corner, it's not huge. Everyone thinks that Riley's just a lot quicker off the corner, but it's actually not. It's, if anything, the MP4 is a little bit quicker off the corner. On the brakes he's pretty much similar, but I think you can pull the Riley up a little bit shorter. But it's when it's wide open like it is there now, the MP4s, you've got not much of a chance, but he's keeping up well there. And again, he has got the tow of five Rileys, so
yeah, this battle just hotted up a whole load more here as well.
Yeah, two car battle now into a five. Front two's starting to pull another little gap though. Maybe Conrad's slightly holding back a bit, but just wants a clean race, does Conrad? Sitting okay in sixth at the minute. And you've got some very sideways. Very well to hold on.
Yeah, Conrad weren't able to capitalise on that, but he's going to have a little bit of a run. But he's under pressure himself behind here.
As you'll see there on the entry, Conrad's possibly carrying a bit too much speed. Need to be very brave on the brakes. Sees it coming, leaves it open though. Will get the run.
He's got an MP4 in his way. I think he's going to be done. Squeezing. Going to be three wide down this back straight. Going to have to hold it around the outside.
Very late on the brakes though, does very well.
Yeah, great defending there. Got the inside line here, it's all good.
A few times in the race just previous, so too wide actually, up until this point. Rod has a little look up the inside, got no chance of that. It's just a shame though that we can't get a huge strength of field actually, compared to the Australians who week in week out get 2 to 3 splits on Thursday. Some big points, upwards of 240.
Yeah, that's a pretty decent SOF. I mean, we'd be happy with that in the Class A series. So, yeah, is it just a case of a lot of people run at different times, or I mean, I know you try and organise on the forum to try and get some big races going.
It's pretty much the one after this where people tend to. It's okay for the Americans and it's not too late for the Euros to jump in together. Obviously we've got the FW31, so...
Yeah, it's a shame we can't broadcast that, actually. Maybe in the future we'll see if we can get a couple of teams of people together, get a couple of channels, like some of our other sim broadcasters out there have done.
We've got a little battle just in front of Conrad. Andre, who's actually just lost a position.
Yeah, that's Bartlett getting through. And again, this field closes back up again.
Trying to see where it was. No, he ran wide. Over the double apex.
I just saw a comrade just skipping the yellow curb there. I mean, how is the Riley with the bumps and curbs generally? I mean, I know we're obviously you're saying it's suffering with the crests, but over the bumps, is this car quite friendly and forgiving?
It can be on some. Next week, I think we're at Zandvoort. Could be mistaken there. But the sausage curbs at Zandvoort, you've got absolutely no chance. In fact, some of the corners at Laguna last week were quite bumpy. And just kicking the car out, but no, it's usually alright actually. I've tried to stay away from that yellow curb actually, on the exit of the pit lane. It does help the car pull it round, but it's very slippy at the same time.
You know, Comrade having to defend more and more at the moment. Every time he gets a chance to have a run, the guys in front, he's put under more pressure.
Yeah, I think it's mainly turn one where he's struggling. Better entry that time. Through the open, different lines. Gone a little bit too wide there, though.
He's going to struggle to hold on to this one as they're side by side.
Going to be the last of the late breakers. Very much at the same point again. Plenty of room given, but.
Yeah, just thought Joe was going to have a little look and try and capitalise there as well.
Definitely thought about it.
Conrad a little bit out of shape going through that corner. I think he's alright though. It looks like Gerard had a little look and stopped him having a proper run down here.
I'm struggling a little bit actually with the double right-hander apex.
Just to let everybody know that we're not ignoring everybody else, there's just not much else on track at the moment. It's this three car battle that's really where everything's at. Everybody else is 3 or 4 seconds away from each other, so.
Sebastian's still going round with that broken car. In third.
Yeah, he actually caught Ricardo up 3/10 of a second that last lap. I don't know how long the pit stop would have been, but He's only dropped 20 seconds, so it's certainly going to be longer than that. At 27 at the moment, so would you estimate, would you say
39, 40 maybe, looking at the pace.
Joe just getting a little bit squirrely over that crest. Luigi, just in front of Conrad.
Just have a look at Chi's lap times. Consistently in the low 17s.
Yeah, 17.8 that last time by, but fastest lap now, which we didn't catch, was a 16.550, so he's absolutely booking out there. I have to say, I think if Sebastian had managed to get past Ricardo earlier on without making that mistake, he would have been able to have given Chi a little run with a 16.714 fastest lap before he got the damage, so... I think the moral of that story is to get a better qualifying time.
Can't get much better though, really. Yeah, some very quick lap times. I've actually not yet hit a 16 this week, so feels very much out of the pace. See, different again. Entries to the, what would you call it, a carousel maybe?
Yeah, kind of.
Horseshoe? Probably not. But plenty of different lines in there and everywhere. It's just a matter of trying to work out what works for you.
All three cars actually taking different entry into that hairpin corner. It appears that Andre's not quite able to keep right on the back of Garnett. So he's pulling just a little bit away. That said, the last time by he was half a second faster, but traffic does pay a difference.
There's a traffic again, doing very well out of the way. Good driving from Dennis. That car looks very familiar for some reason.
Right, let's just have a quick check in with the leaders. Let's start with Johan. Up to a 4.1 second lead from Alisson at the moment. That's Russ behind him, so I'm not sure what's going on with the overlay there. Nice. That's because he's there in I see. But yeah, Luigi here looks like he's got about a 7 second lead over Luigi, so he's pulling away quite comfortably.
Trying to find my little piece of software that tells me, and I can't see on the desktop.
Well, he looks pretty confident in the car. Let's just jump on board and just watch as he puts a lap on one of the MP4s. I do like the sound of the McLaren, although it's, I wouldn't say necessarily authentic. It is one of the better sounding cars we've got from inside the cockpit.
I'm not sure if we've missed this off screen, but looks like Gerard's through on Conrad.
Let's just have a quick jump back a minute and just have a quick look. See what we can catch. I think he's already got him.
Yeah, it was actually
down the straight, wasn't it, looking at it. Got a slipstream of one of the back markers in front.
In fact, I think it was that back marker that's letting through. Come into the airpin. And I'm just behind Russ, the back marker. Trying to follow his line. See how that goes on now.
I have to say, for the most part, everybody's still out. We've just lost three people at the moment. Obviously, one didn't start as well. So, yeah, compared to what we were seeing last week with guys crashing off all over the place, it's been a pretty tidy race.
Oh, again, Conrad Luton's in another position. What does he? He's on the outside. Remember that one went.
Wait until the hairpin before we jump back to the live action, because there's a lot going on.
Joe made a little mistake actually. Run it wide and onto the grass, not coming back through. Joe's definitely got the better of Conrad there. Got about 2-3 second gap on him now, so probably slightly holding him up. Through, see if there's anything else going on.
Yeah, just a quick look at the leader at the moment. Looks nice and solid out there, very, very comfortable. Car looks planted underneath him actually, so he's supposed to have a cracking little set on that. Just to let you guys know, those that are watching, stay tuned. We will just break the broadcast very, very shortly, just while we go to the Road to Pro series after this race, but yeah, just come straight back. We've got that, and also don't forget to tune in on Saturday mornings if you fancy watching a bit of the Australian V8 Supercar having a blast. Apex Racing League doing that. If you're interested in that series, just go along into the V8 forum and put your name down. Just got 4 races left of this season, but sign-ups are open all throughout the calendar, so... Actually, while I'm doing the plug-in, let's go full-on and just thank the ApexRacingLeague.com for supporting us with the broadcasts. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter and on Facebook. And a big shout-out to our main sponsors as well, so GTO Omega, Racing.com, AC Sim Equipment, Kimmy's Royal Fencing, and SimGarage.com.
Yeah, and while that was going on, nothing really much happened on track. The leader trying to get past the back marker in the MP4s.
Claudia not going so wide this time. Learned the lessons from earlier on in the race.
Well, there you go, the leader in the MP4 showing what to really do. The two bottling cars coming through. Conrad and Joe still in a distant battle. Joe goes up the inside. Later on the brakes, Joe's still got a good run.
The camera jumps away, typically. Just jump back to the action.
God, holds on this time round.
Yeah, lap 34, tyres are going to be getting a little greasy. Not got too much longer left.
In fact, it was a good little jump where it went to. Just in front of these two. Andre and Gerard had another little battle.
Yeah, it just goes to show that perhaps Gerard was being held up by Conrad earlier on, and had he had got past a little bit earlier, he might have had a run on Andre.
Tyre's now starting to feel a little bit worn, especially in the front. And a quick look after my race, and they were down into the 73s. What's that? Where? But the lap time doesn't really tend to drop off, actually.
No, we're still looking at people running around in the 17s, so... I think that's just everything that's wrong with the tyre at the moment, isn't it? So that they just hold on forever. A lot of guys out there obviously wanting the lateral grip issues sorted out with it, but... I think the worst problem for most people is how it how the degradation works.
Some cars it's actually really good, other cars it's just completely terrible.
Just say one car I do want to drive at some point is GT40 again, because I had a lot of reviews saying it's probably the best road car on the sim at the moment as far as the physics go.
Gerard looks to the inside, to the open.
Tries to switch. Heavy underbraking, just wants to get his nose in there. Can't quite do it. Andre closes the door.
Greenwood parking on the apex there. A little bit too far back though. Coming into the next braking zone, possibly the last. Passing point. Make sure what a bit of pressure from two battling cars can do. Got Burnett starting to pull away from these two.
Yeah, quite considerably actually. Look at that.
And again, these two are starting to pull away from Conrad, who's got the leader behind him.
Great little shot there, just looking back from the gearbox of Andre's car. You can just see when you're down this low, you can just see all the undulations in the track surface. How it's affecting the car. So we've seen the distance. Conrad just letting the leader go through. I have to say apologies to the MP4 drivers, we've not given you much coverage today, but then you haven't given us much reason to get in there and start tussling with each other. Could spice things up here actually as he comes through this this battle. Keep an eye on him for a second and just see what happens.
He's just got an MP4 to navigate first of all. He's on the inside, turn one.
MP4 didn't know which way to go there. Left, right, left, nope. Conrad gets through, gets a bit of breathing room. It's just what he needed. Only got a few laps to deal with, just about 3 minutes left.
Yeah, on lap 38 now from the leader. Maybe my prediction was wrong and we could go even longer. I'm actually just sitting on board with the... cheer the minute, just listening to how he's driving. He's doing exactly what I was saying. Just letting the car run in short shifts. Pretty much just not overdriving the car at all, it's just let it where it wants to go. Definitely understands this car very well. Been in the 17th the whole way through this race.
It just seems to me like he's focusing so much more on the exit of the corner and making sure that that's as clean as possible, so he's getting maximum drive out of the corners. However he's doing, it's working well for him as he just darts up the inside over the crest. White flags come out, so it'll be the last lap for the leader.
Conrad's still there.
Ooh, bit of a moment for him there. He's coming down the hill. Just stick with him just to watch this, and then we'll jump to Conrad just to make sure, see how he holds up. And Gerard, I think he's going to have another lap as well to try and get Andre.
Yeah, these two in front have got another lap.
She has indeed taken the victory here today. At Mid-Ohio, fantastic drive, some 17 seconds in front of Ricardo. Obviously hasn't crossed the line, but will be. Sebastian stayed out with that damaged car in third place. Conrad does indeed come across with seventh, with Joe followed him closely in eighth. Let's just see if we can jump on with Garnett and Andre. Just watch these few. Just this last lap.
Garnett looks a little bit safe.
Yeah, he's going to be alright. I think Andre's safe as well, to be fair, at this point in time. So it's all going to be about going into this last corner, maybe some sort of last ditch attempt on the very last corner. Ooh, a little bump and run, maybe. Let's take it NASCAR style. Yeah, lap 40, so you weren't wrong with your prediction. As a look up the inside, thinks about getting his nose there. Andre, just sensible, just knows that he's going to have the inside for the next corner. Run down to the line, but he's got him covered.
Definitely some great racing there till the end. Shame about the MP4s. Spreading out a little bit too much.
Fortunately, like always, the standings just get a little bit messed on the official sessions with the multi-class. People will leave, so I can't give you the rundown, but you can see it all on the ticker.
Yeah, so Chi gets the win, Ricardo in second, like you said, 17 seconds behind. And then Sebastian, 1 minute and 2 seconds actually behind Chi because of that damage. A few more laps and he would have been under a lot of pressure actually.
Yeah, managed to save his pride and not get himself lapped.
And then Johan again takes the win this time, like Mosport.
Yeah,
Canadian tyre.
We didn't see Johan cross the line there, so apologies for that.
Luigi kept it in second for the MP4s as well, so definitely some good racing. We only had what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people actually who didn't make it to the end. PJ looks like he didn't start.
Yeah, I think that was one. Yeah, I think you're right. PJ didn't get on there, registered, but didn't get on. Dennis 10 laps down, Andy Pierce 20 laps down, obviously he had some issues. Adam Volkia,
So.
Right. Onwards we go. I don't expect we'll get any drivers from the series in. There's not many know that we cover it yet. I think the few of the regulars do, so maybe we'll get a couple in towards the end of the season just to tell us a little bit about their race, how it went. But for now, that just about wraps up the coverage of the Grand Am series, and we will be back in about 5 minutes for the Road to Pro FW31 Class A strength of field race. I've been Alex Simpson, my co-commentator.
And Ian Prescott.
We will see you potentially next week. Dean, are you thinking about commentating or are you going to be driving?
I'm not sure.
Let's have a look. Where
what? On that bombshell.
Road Atlanta, so.
Ooh, Road Atlanta. Ooh.
I think we might be racing that one.
Well, hopefully being myself and somebody else in the comments box. Have to try and get hold of Mr. Woodhouse very early, commentator last week. But anyway, from us, it's farewell for Mid-Ohio, and we will see you next week.
Time for those most famous words in motorsports. Travis, start your engines!
Conti comes up at a corner number four, and the checkered flag, he wins his first.